Hello everyone, and this is Tech Geeky Aarti. We will discuss here how to create JSON data in MySQL. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. This tutorial includes JSON data types, JSON arrays, JSON objects, nesting within JSON, create table with JSON field, inserting data in JSON field, normalization, JSON merge preserve function. The full form of JSON is JavaScript Object Notation. Because JSON format is identical to JavaScript object codes. Here is an example of this code. In this code, we format the data in the key value pair, means key colon value, comma, another key colon value, and enclosed within curly brackets. This makes JSON objects. JSON values can have following data types. It can be strings, numbers, null values. Null means if data is unknown or unavailable, you can fill in as null. Booleans have two values, true, false. JSON strings require double quotes. Means if you are writing a name or any word, alphabetical word, then this should be enclosed within double quotes. That will make it a string. Don't enclose null and boolean values with double quote marks, or JSON will identify it as a string, not the null or booleans. Date time, these can be also used as a JSON values. Functions, current time tells the current time, now also tells the current time and date. So these functions can be used as JSON values too. And keys in JSON objects must be strings. So data is formatted in key value pair. So values can have these many data types, but keys should be strings. JSON arrays, a list of JSON values separated by commas, enclosed within square brackets. Here is an example. So this is a string, boolean, null, and number. This is the list of JSON values and we have enclosed it within the square bracket. This will make it a JSON array. We can also create a JSON array using a function JSON underscore array, and inside the round bracket we can give the list of values like value 1, 2, 3 separated by commas. Here is an example. Number, string, null, boolean, and the function, we have listed them and enclosed inside the round brackets using the JSON array function. If we execute it, it will give us the same result as this example. It will create a JSON array enclosed within the square bracket. You can see current time function is showing the current time when we take out the output. JSON objects are the list of key value pairs, key colon value, enclosed within curly brackets. Here is an example. We can also input multiple key value pairs, but keys must be string, and values can have different data types. Like here, name is a string, age, city, they are strings, but values could be string, number, and other data types. We can also create JSON object using JSON underscore object function, and inside the round brackets we need to list key value pairs in order, like first key, then comma, first value, comma, second key, then comma, second value. Here is an example. JSON underscore object, inside the round brackets I have listed first key as ID and its value 101. And then the second key name and its value Mary. If we execute it, it will create a JSON object using key colon value format and enclosed within curly bracket. Just keep one thing in your mind, parameters or values inside JSON object function should be even. Like you will give two values or four or six in even numbers. If values are odd, JSON object cannot make a key value pair and will throw an error. Nesting within JSON arrays and JSON objects. You can nest a JSON object and another JSON array inside a JSON array. Like here is a JSON array. You can say it is enclosed within square brackets. And this one is the JSON object. It is nested inside JSON array as an element. And here is another JSON array, sweet, sour. And it is also nested inside this JSON array. Similarly, for JSON objects, we can nest a JSON array or JSON object inside the main JSON object. Like this is a JSON object, key1, val1, key2. Key can have multiple values and we can list them as a JSON array, like here you can see. Next is, let's apply whatever we have learned so far. So we will create a table with JSON field here. To create a table, we will use create table statement. Then schema name dot table name. Table name is products here. We are making a table of products with three columns, ID, name, and attributes. Data type of ID is integer. Data type of name is varchar. And the third column is having the JSON data type. So here you have to give the data type as JSON. And it will create a table with three columns, ID, name, attributes, with their respective data types. Next is, we are going to insert data in JSON field. To insert the data, we are going to use insert into and values statement. So insert into schema name dot table name, and inside the round brackets we will give the column names, ID, name, attributes. And after values statement, we are going to give the values of each column. Like value of ID is 101, product name is Sony TV, and attributes or properties of this product we are going to list here in attributes column as JSON data types. So we have to create JSON object and JSON arrays and format the data in only JSON object and JSON array. Properties of this product is screen 50 inch, so we will list this as a key value pair. The screen is the value of this key. Second key is ports. There are two ports, so we can create a JSON array of these values, HDMI and USB. Third key is speakers, and its value has two key value pairs, means left speaker has 10 watt and right speaker has 10 watt. So we can format data here as JSON object, like left 10 watt, right colon 10 watt. This way we can format the JSON data type. The output would look like this. You can see attributes column. We can see first key is ports, its values. Second key is screen, its value. Third key is speaker and its values. In the output, keys are sorted here. Like I have inserted screen key first and then the ports key. But in the output, you can see ports key comes first and screen second, and then it's because keys are sorted as the part of normalization. In the alphabetical order, P comes first before S. So ports will come first, then screen. You can also use JSON object and JSON array to create JSON data in attributes column. You have to use same command, insert into and values. Instead of using curly brackets and square brackets, we are using JSON object and JSON array. Let's compare these two formats. So here we have created JSON data using curly brackets and square brackets for objects and arrays. Here we are using functions. First we used JSON object, and then inside the round brackets we are listing key value pairs. First key is key, comma, first value 50 inch, comma, second key ports, comma, and its value is a JSON array. So I use JSON array object to list HDMI and USB. Third key is speaker, its values is a JSON object. So I have used JSON underscore object and list key value pairs inside the round bracket. You can use any format, they both will output same result. Consider using JSON object and JSON array functions to avoid SQL syntax error. Next is duplicate keys or normalization. If you mention same key more than once, it retains only last key value pair and removes other key value pairs. This is called normalization, and also the part of normalization, object keys are sorted as we have seen before. Let's give me an example. So we are inserting one more insert into and values statement we are using here. And here inside the JSON object, I am giving screen 50 inch, comma screen 60 inch. I am giving the same key screen two times with different values, 50 inch and 60 inch. And it will retain only the last value, that is the 60 inch. It will remove the 50 inch value. Let's see the output. In the output, you can see screen colon 60 inch only is printed and 50 inch is removed. Next function is JSON merge pizzer. This merges two or more JSON objects and creates single combined JSON object. Here in this example, I'm using JSON merge and pizzer function, and inside the round brackets we are giving two JSON objects. First JSON object is this that you have seen before, and second JSON object is this one. And here I have created JSON object using curly brackets. So JSON merge pizzer function will merge these two JSON objects into one single. Here is the output. It has added monitor type key and value pair into the previous JSON object. Here is another example of JSON merge pizzer function, where it is preserving the key values. Like if you have given three JSON objects inside this function with the same key value screen, 50 inch, 60 inch and 70 inch, what it will do, it will not remove any value. It will actually make a list of values and put it in the JSON array, so and merge it into single JSON object. So here is the output. You can get one error here, like error code 1582, like if you are giving only one JSON object inside the JSON merge pizzer, then it will throw an error. You need at least two JSON objects to merge inside. Whenever you need to create data as key value pairs in a separate table, you should consider using a JSON data type field, as it can heavily compress your database design. If you have any topics you want me to cover in future videos, kindly comment in the box. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.